Hello, Mr. Tarun. Today, we're going to start talking about parabolas. And I'll see if I can get this video done in 15 minutes, and if not, it'll be two parts. Let's talk about transformations. We learned those not very long ago, and I'm going to just put up here a very basic parabola, which is y equals x squared. Now, do you remember what the transformations were like? Say if I wanted to take this parabola and move it right to and down 3 units and draw the parabola like this. Remember what made those parabolas and those 7 parent functions that we studied move around like that? Left, down, flip, horizontal flips, and all that other kind of good stuff? Well, if you do, great, and if you don't, let me help you out here. This is going to be f of x or y. Now, I've moved this parabola to the right and down. Do you remember how the left and right movement showed up? That was when we had a plus or minus inside the function itself. So the function is a power of 2. So I'm going to have, for this movement to the right, x minus 2 inside my function. Now, what else did I do with this original parent function, this original parent parabola? I moved it down 3. So where was your vertical shift at? That was the constant at the end of your equation. So minus 3 will take this parabola, this parent function, and move it down 3 places. Now, what caused the vertical flips when we studied transformations of functions? That was when your graph started off with a negative value. So this red equation now is the equation of this parent function, which is a parabola flip down, move to the right, 2, and move down 3. This was the vertical flip, the minus 2 is the movement to the right, and the negative 3 at the end was our shift down. Well, the transformations chapter of our book, or if you want to go back and watch another video, if you're not in my class, helps us understand where the standard form of a parabola comes from. The standard form of parabolas is f of x equals plus or minus a, that's possibly a vertical flip. A is a vertical stretch. If a is larger than 1, the graph is going to get pulled vertically. And it'll appear to be skinnier, though it's really not. If a is less than 1, the graph has been compressed from your transformation section. X minus h squared plus k. This is the standard form of a parabola, which is one of the conic sections that we're going to learn about today. Now, when you look at this standard form, you can look at this and tell a lot about the graph. You can tell where the vertex is. This vertex of the parabola is at 2, negative 3. Well, you can see that right here. It's 2. We want to change that sign when we take it out of the parentheses, negative 3. Or, in standard form, the vertex is hk. So hopefully that looks familiar now to the standard form getting tied into the transformation section that we covered a few weeks ago. What else is in here? Well, all parabolas have an axis of symmetry, a line that you can put down the middle of the parabola. We're only going to do vertical parabolas, by the way, today, so that's going to be when x is squared. If y is squared, the parabolas are going to be horizontal. We'll study those later in the year. So if you have an x squared term, you have a vertical line, which is an axis of symmetry. Well, vertical lines are in the form of x equals a number. Well, what is the x value that axis of symmetry is going to go through? It's going to go through the vertex. So it's going to be x equals h, or x equals whatever the x component is of your vertex. In this case, this would be x equals positive 2 for the axis of symmetry. There's some other things we can find that we're going to do in a minute, like x and y intercepts. And also, a parabola, a graph has a relative maximum when it has a peak and then it falls on both sides. So parabolas, this red parabola, will also have a relative maximum. The relative maximum will be at 2, negative 3. And we've been talking about domain and range again this year as well. The domain, what x values does this graph include? All of them. All the ones from negative infinity to positive infinity. What are the range? The range is going to be from negative 3 down to negative infinity. And just in case you need some help with that, domain are your x's, and we're going to be looking at the red graph. And with some math classes, you might say it's all real numbers. In pre-calc, we would say that's from negative infinity to positive infinity, or in calculus. The range of that particular example, the red parabola, well, that's your y values, and the largest y value is negative 3, and it goes down from there. So that would be y is less than or equal to negative 3. Interval notation, which my kids are using, starts with the smallest y value, and the smallest y value is 0, going up to a y value of negative 3, and the square bracket will indicate that the value of negative 3 is actually used. So, there we go, a little tie-in between old chapter about, or old section about transformations, left, right, horizontal movements, up and down movements, vertical flips, and how that shows you where we get the standard form of a parabola. Now, most of our work today from here on out is going to be about working with the general form of a parabola. And so let's do that. We're going to do one example, graph it, and find solutions, and do a nice graph, not just a sketch like I've been doing with my students lately.
La la la, la 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 la.
Okay, that's clean enough. Let's take a look at this example of a parabola. We got y equals negative 2x plus 3x squared minus 4. Okay, well now this parabola is not what we would call in general form, because in general form you want your exponents to count down as you go to the right. And mine don't. I have an exponent of 1 and then 2. So I'm going to rewrite this as y equals 3x squared minus 2x minus 4, and go into, let me do function notation. The general form of a parabola is ax squared plus bx plus c. And we're going to graph this parabola in general form. Later on this year, we will be studying conic sections a lot, and we'll be using completing the square process to put this general form into standard form. But we're not doing completing the square today and putting these into standard form. So what if you're given a parabola and you're asked to graph the parabola in this form? Well, step one is to find the x of the vertex, and that's found by doing negative b over 2a, which is negative, negative 2, because it's a, b, and c, over 2a, and this is going to come out to be 2 over 6, or 1 third. Okay, great. I'm starting to understand where the vertex is at. Now, the y part of the vertex, we're going to find that by just taking this x value and plugging it back into the function. So that's going to be 3 times 1 third squared minus 2 times 1 third minus 4. That's going to be 3 times 1 ninth minus 2 thirds minus 4. That little fraction work today is going to be 1 third minus 2 thirds. Now, I want to put all three of these numbers together. My 4 has a denominator of 1. So I'm going to multiply the top and bottom by 3 so we have a common denominator. And that will be negative 3. Whoops, no, it won't. It'll be negative 12, yes, minus 12 over 3. So 1 minus 2 is negative 1. Negative 1 minus 12 is negative 13. And this parabola has a vertex which is at 1 third negative 13 over 3. Good. Now here's what I got so far. I'm going to have to erase this, by the way, because I don't think I'll fit all this on my sketch. But 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's see if this is enough to make our sketch. Our vertex is at 1 third, comma, negative 3 over 13. Well, how many 3's are in 13? 4, leaving your remainder of 1, so that's going to be negative 4 and 1 third, so a bit less than negative 4. So, need to make another tick mark. 1/3, and a little bit past 4. So 4 and 1/3, it's about right there is the vertex. Now, you see this leading coefficient? When our leading coefficients are positive, our parabolas are going to open up. If this 3 were negative, it would open down. So I know that my parabola is now going to go up from here. What other points could we easily find to help us graph this parabola, not just a sketch? Let's take a look at the y-intercept. For a y-intercept, you want to let x equal 0. When you cross the y-axis, what is x? There is no horizontal movement, so x is 0. Now, that'll be fairly easy to do. F of 0, I'm switching from y to function notation, is going to be 3 times 0 squared minus 2 times 0 minus 4. And so f of 0, my y-intercept, is going to be negative 4. So I got another point right here. Shall I color code that? My y-intercept is right here. Okay, good. Now I am going to have to erase some of this work to help us find the x-intercept, because that's going to involve either factoring or the quadratic. Now I've shown you a little bit of factoring recently, so I'm going to remind you how to do the quadratic formula again. Which actually I've done that recently as well, but that's what we're doing. So anyway, y-intercept, let x equal 0. We're about to find the x-intercept by letting y equal 0. Whew, almost erased my problem. Okay. So, I want to find the next intercept of this. That means let y equal 0. So what I want to do is solve for, again, the x-intercept is solve this equation. 3x squared minus 2x minus 4 equals 0. All right, let's see what it looks like. With the quadratic formula, in case you didn't remember what that is, the quadratic formula is x equals negative b plus or minus square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. You still with me? All right. So we're going to apply this quadratic formula to this quadratic equation that is in general form, and that means this is a, which is 3, b is going to be negative 2, and c is going to be negative 4. So that's going to be x equals negative b, watch the parentheses when you plug in these numbers, it helps, times b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. That's going to be 2 plus or minus 4 plus, that's 12 and 4 is 48. Over 6, that's going to be 2 plus or minus the square root of 52 over 6. Now, if you want to reduce this and be like an exact form, 52 is, let's see here, the square root of 4 times the square root of 13 over 6. So this in exact form is 2 plus or minus 2 square root of 13. You know where that is on the x-axis? I don't either. So if you type this into your calculator or this into your calculator to get your decimal approximations, I'm going to cheat with my notes, it's negative 0.87 and 1.5. Okay, so this is how you solve a quadratic equation. You solve it with quadratic formula, and I'm pretty sure this could have been done with factoring as well. Now, that means that I have an x-intercept at negative 0.87. So, negative 0.87, positive 1.5, and voila, we have our parabola. Let's see here, domain, as I do circles. Domain, before I run out of time, is going to be my x's from negative infinity to positive infinity. That graph will open up forever. The range is going to be for my y values. The smallest y value is negative 4. I erased it. Oh no! 4.33 to infinity. And the axis of symmetry is a vertical line, and it's going to be x equals. Man, I erased everything too fast. Well, whatever that x value was, the vertex, that is the axis of symmetry. Woo! All right, go do your homework. Thank you very, very much.